Mary Beth.
How are you, Arthur?
Fine. How are you?
Well, I'm well, I think. It's been quite a run we've had, but we're still alive.
So, no regrets?
Regrets for what?
Well, for joining this band of maniacs.
If you're a girl without means in this world, life is very scary. You boys care for me before no one cared for me. Well, life weren't very nice, Arthur. Not after Mama got typhoid, and that was a long time ago.
Sure.
What about you? I heard you ran into that Mary girl.
Yep.
And?
Got me thinking how that all ended. Long time ago now.
What happened?
Well, she didn't love me enough, I guess. Or I wouldn't change.
Huh. Well, she was a fool then, Arthur.
Well, she put a lot of good years in on an outlaw. She definitely was a fool.
In these books, life seems so simple, but in reality, I can't make head nor tail of it.
Mr. Morgan! Mr. Morgan, we have a problem. A real problem. It's Tilly.
What?
She's been taken by them foreman brothers she used to run with. Come along!
The foreman brothers? What are they doing here?
Well, I don't know what they've been doing here, but I can tell you what they're going to be doing here. Dying.
Sure. Do we need more guns?
You and I can handle this, Arthur.
Where are we heading?
I'll tell you on the way. Just get going. All right, head for Rhodes. And quick!
She's in Rhodes?
No. She's at a place called Bradley's House, just west of there.
How do you know?
When we first got here, she told me she was worried that our camp was near a safe house that gang she ran with used from time to time.
And you told Dutch?
No. She spoke to me in confidence. I suppose I didn't think it would be a problem.
Now it is.
Oh, yes.
What do they want with her anyway? I think I saw one of the foremans hassling her in Valentine.
Yes, they probably followed us down here. You don't know what happened? She killed one of them, for good reason, but clearly they don't see it that way.
Tilly?
Yes. Young Tilly Jackson isn't as sweet and innocent as you might think. But like I say, she was defending herself. She fled and fell in with us right after that. I just hope we can get to her in time.
That's not too far.
If they touched a single hair on that girl's head, I will eviscerate the sons of bitches. Anyway, talking to folks disappear. Have you seen that boy Kieran since the party for Jack? Okay, I think that's the place up ahead.
I think there's a guard.
I'll deal with him.
What you want with him?
Kind sir, we're lost and in need of some help.
Get out of here!
Oh, I see that kindly face of yours, and I know that for the right inducement, a gentleman such as yourself could be mighty kind.
Now get out of here.
Oh, now you keep saying that. You don't mean nothing by it.
I said...
You said your last words. Well, what are you waiting for? Get in there and fight. Go.
Shit! What the hell are you doing? What's going on?
It's okay, Miss Tilly. Now, let's get you out of here.
I thought there was...
Yeah, it don't matter what you thought. It's okay. All right, let's go.
Oh, come along, miss. Thank you, both of you.
What happened?
It was Anthony Foreman. He thinks he owns me.
I remember. Where is he?
He went out hunting or something. There were five of them, I think.
Well, we killed those fellas there.
There they are.
Come on.
Tilly, grab that gun. Anyone approaches, shoot them.
Oh, don't worry. I'll be just fine. Now catch that bastard. The one in front of the boat. Bring him back alive. I ain't done with him yet.
All right, get after them. You hit the wrong girl! You've got a couple more seconds to regret what you did! We're coming for you! sure you tie him up real good.
Open me like a damn steer.
Make these nice and tight.
All right, you bring that bastard back to Tilly so we can all have a nice little chat. I'm gonna head over there now to check she's okay.
With pleasure.
I'll take his horse. He won't be.
You have the first idea what you're getting into.
Shut the hell up.
What the hell? You have the first idea what you're getting into. I'm Anthony Foreman.
Well, thanks for the introduction, Anthony. Is that Foreman with an A? I want the Undertaker to spell it right.
Funny bastard. Oh, shit. Funny bastard. Who are you running with?
She didn't tell you?
She didn't tell you?
Coward.
All right, damn it.
Your man.
Bring him here. Dump him on the ground here. I want to get a good look at this monster.
So he's still alive then?
Yes.
You see this girl? You leave her alone.
She killed my cousin.
Your goddamn cousin had it coming, Anthony Foreman.
I don't care if she shot your daddy and cooked your mama for breakfast. She's mine. She ain't yours.
You know, a friend of mine, he always says... Revenge is a fool's game. Now, you want all your boys dead? She had her reasons.
We was family, Tilly Jackson.
You Foreman boys ain't no kind of family I want.
Kill him, Arthur!
You want that?
I want him to go away and tell the remaining of his cousins and the clowns he rides with to leave me alone!
Now, you think you can do that, Anthony? Or should I... slit your throat and just save us all the bother.
I'll leave you alone. History is done.
History is never done. It's your call, Arthur. But I'd slit his throat. Go on.
All right, you.
Come on. Let's get you home.
Now get out of here. Lady, you're in a bad spot, huh?
My horse collapsed. Now my leg's stuck. What does it look like? I can't get free.
All right, hold your horses.
Please,
oh,
help
sorry,
me.
That's not funny.
Go on. Go on, you got it. Oh, thank you.
Yeah.
I don't know what I would have done if you hadn't come by.
No problem.
You might have been stuck there forever. Oh, Moses. Poor baby.
Would you like a ride home, ma'am?
Oh, thank you. You're a good man. Could you take me to Saint Denis? It's far. I know.
No problem.
You're a real angel, you know? Two men gone by not long before you did and just kept right on going.
Yeah, that ain't much surprise.
I don't know what I'll do now without my Moses. I've been saving for a month to go visit my father. Now he'll just be waiting on me.
That's tough. But at least you're alive and walking. I'm sure your father will be happy about that.
Headed out this morning to see my father, but I heard some of those damn raiders off ahead and tore right through some thick brush. Poor Moses twisted his leg. We went on as long as we could, but he gave out right where you found me. We just weren't meant for that kind of ride, and I just got scared.
Sure. Sounds like you did the right thing, even if it cost.
Guess I'm lucky my leg didn't break in the fall. My cousin Lucy broke her arm. They did her up in plaster of Paris.
You don't say.
One night, some real fancy-looking fella got curious about that plaster cast. Said he wanted to know what it felt like. Guess he got too curious. Poor Lucy was hollering all night. Her arm never did heal straight. Anyway, I'm glad my leg ain't broke as all. Sorry, I'm talking too much. Still too shook up.
Well, that's all right, ma'am. You're safe now.
You familiar with Saint Denis at all? I'm over on the eastern side. Head toward the big cemetery. Look at all this. They say this is what the future looks like, and I say it's filthy. You know, I like to watch the boats sometimes, but there stinks from them towers. Guess I should get used to it if it's the future and all.
Not a future I want any part in.
Me neither, mister, but what can we do? We just two people.
You got a problem?
East looks like home. Ride like a madman. I'm close now. Thank you. I really love that horse. Poor baby. You like carrots, you know? He'd eat him right out of my palm. He knew me by the sound of my voice, he did.
It's always hard losing a good animal.
We're here. I'd still be stuck there if not for you. Thank you again.
Just glad I found you. You really don't. Well, thank you.
close up shop. Heaven knows where I'll find another as good.
There you are, dear boy.
Yes, here I am.
Well, we're going to need to get you smartened up a bit.
Why?
Well, you can't play at the tables on a Lanahassee riverboat looking like this.
You can't?
Not if you want to fit in so well that no one will realize you're there to rob the place. Now, come on.
Are we still doing that?
Of course. We're going to fix you up so fine, no one will notice a thing.
Hello. Can I help you, gentlemen?
Yes, my friend here is in need of a new suit.
Make this gentleman look like the Duke he really is. It was the English's fault his grandfather had to emigrate. A bitter and jealous people. You can see the aristocrat in his profile. The heavy brow from all the inbreeding.
Come on, let's get you to the barber.
Sure.
Good luck tonight, gentlemen.
Herr Strauss has scoped the whole thing out. It's quite ingenious, actually.
What is?
The action he has planned. Indeed, it's not much of an action at all. You play cards and win. And you're going to bet very big and flamboyantly while you win. And everyone's going to think you're some new money from the oil fields come to lay it on thick and drunk. All the while, Herr Strauss will be signaling you in your line of sight. When you bust the place, they'll take you upstairs to pay you off. And that is when Javier comes in, and you take whatever you want.
You don't think they might see an armed Mexican coming into the safe with me?
Sure, they might, but perhaps not. You will see.
The suspense is killing me.
Oh, don't be so jaded. We both know this is just the kind of innocent fun you thrive on.
Well, after the past couple of months, armed robbery don't seem such an innocent pastime.
No, but we, you, all of us, will be done here soon.
I hope so.
Come on. Could you smarten up my dear hick friend here? This unlikely fellow has made himself a fortune in the oil fields and learned himself not a lick of manners or gentlemanly deportment.
Well, very good, sir.
No, it's not good. Not
there,
good at all.
Very
not
smart.
Not that they're gonna let... Come on, let's get to the docks. I've arranged some transportation for us.
Hope you have a successful evening, gentlemen.
I heard
George!
The
to the Grand Corrigan, please.
Grand Corrigan, sir.
Well, look at you! From Toad to Prince.
Yeah, this is a bit much, ain't it? The coach?
We can't whinny up there on horses like a bunch of countrified yokels. You're a brash oil man. Money to burn. Which reminds me, no shuffling and mumbling. Puff your chest out. Get outside yourself.
Yeah, all right, all right. St. Hamlin. So, who's a mark?
Are you all right, by the way, the driver?
Oh, yes. Don't worry. George and I go way back. It's a man called Desmond Blythe. Made a fortune in hosiery of all things. Likes to play fast and always keep some extra collateral in the safe upstairs.
So, if Strauss is sitting behind him, how does he know what cards I got?
He won't. But the dealer has recently become a very good friend of mine.
Another one.
Don't worry, Arthur. We're all the authors of our own good fortune. He'll make sure you get the right cards.
What could possibly go wrong?
Indeed.
And what money am I playing with?
Don't worry. That has all been arranged. Your chips will be waiting for you. There she is. Come on.
weaponry here. They are searchers when we get on. George, we'll collect these from you later.
Very good, sir.
Thank you, George.
Good luck, sir.
Now remember what I said, Arthur. Everyone is the author of his own good fortune.
Yes, yes, believe me, I heard every word.
Watch Strauss, listen to the dealer, and this should be a very lucky night. There they are.
Gentlemen, how wonderful to see you. Arthur, you remember this pair of boys we met in New York? Come on. Champagne is on dear old Arthur. He's rich as can be and feeling luckier than a turkey that survived Thanksgiving.
Hello, gentlemen.
Hello, dear boy. Come on, come on, let's head aboard. Drinks on Arthur. Champagne.
I'm afraid we require all patrons to hand over their guns.
Good time. The tables await.
I'll go find myself a change of clothes.
Okay.
You seem unsure.
Robbing a heavily armed riverboat without a gun tends to bring out the self-doubt in me.
These people are virtually idiots. This is simple stuff. Now have a good time, but don't lose too much money or your wife is going to kill me.
Whatever you say.
Now where can I get a cocktail?
Take a seat, sir.
Good evening, gentlemen. Arthur Callahan. Sorry I'm late. I had some unfinished business at the bar.
Hey, Desmond Blythe.
Evening.
Not to worry. Welcome to the game, Mr. Callahan. Okay, gentlemen, let's play.
I hope you're a player. Been too many cowards at these tables recently. Nothing less dignified than a man afraid to lose a little money.
Look at this! Chips already stacked up, waiting for me. I like this joint already.
We aim to please, sir.
So, how are we all faring?
Some better than others.
If we all fared the same in life now, where would the fun be?
Quiet.
Wait, not Desmond Blythe, the hosiery king. I should have brought my other wallet.
Not my preferred title, but yes, you should have. Okay, sorry, boys, I'm taking it all.
We'll see about that.
To hell with it. Here we go, then.
Well, hello, my ladies.
Mr. Blythe wins with three queens.
Goodbye, gentlemen. I guess it's just you and me now, friend.
Yes, it is.
Time to see if you're really the man you seem to think you are.
Likewise, Mr. Blythe.
So what business are you in, Mr. Callahan?
I'm an oil man, for my sins.
Funny, I haven't heard of you.
Oh, you will. You know, I thought about getting in a hosiery, but I just look better in a suit.
I would stick to oil, Mr. Callahan. I don't think you have a future on the stage.
You sound just like my wife.
Sometime before 1900 would be nice. Okay, Mr. Callahan, I'm all in.
I'll call. Interesting.
They're cowgirls. Ship! Ship!
I guess my luck held.
Is that you done?
Done?
Bust. Or, you got something else to play with.
Meaning?
Well, I heard there were some big boys on this boat. Maybe that's not you. No offense.
Sit your hillbilly ass down.
Why?
I got a watch.
Look at you.
An expensive one. Real fine. Swiss. A Reutlinger, no less. It's in the safe upstairs. It's worth more than you.
Okay. I trust you.
Now play.
As you wish.
So, you must know Leviticus Cornwall, big oil man like you.
Of course, we've crossed paths. I was fortunate enough to tour a little operation heads up in New Hanover.
Let's not waste any more time here. All in.
Don't worry, sir. Everyone is the author of his own good fortune.
Well, nothing ventured, nothing gained. Hurricane.
Very good, but not good enough.
Shit. Uh-oh. Yes, you little beauty.
Hard lines, Mr. Blythe. Mr. Callahan wins with an ace-high diamond flush.
God damn you!
No offense.
None taken.
Well played, sir.
Unlucky, Desmond.
Now, forgive my lack of discretion, but, where might I find this watch?
It's upstairs. Shall we go and have a look?
Why not?
Gentlemen.
Please, cash these out for me.
I started last week.
Good. Sure. Perhaps you could escort us up to the office.
Yes, of course, sir.
Thank you.
Follow me, gentlemen.
Come with me, sir.
How do you do?
You're having quite the night.
Yeah, so far.
I cannot believe someone gave a greaser a job.
We live in strange times.
Personally, I wouldn't trust one with a gun, but fear not. I've got my own little lawgiver right here.
Very good.
Next, we'll be hiring Negroes.
Yeah, I know.
I think you're going to like this watch, sir. I saw it earlier, and it really is a handsome piece. Foreign made, but you can't have everything.
Indeed.
Well, here we are. Just give me 1 second, sir.
Of course, take your time. Don't reach for that gun.
Take his gun, Arthur.
I guess you were right. Only an idiot would give a greaser a gun.
Idiot, huh?
Shit, let's hope no one heard that. Quick, clear the safe. Let's get out of here. Can't believe that asshole had another gun.
The view in here is looking pretty good.
How much is there?
Must be a few thousand, plus the watch.
Nice. Now let's get out of here. Come on. Let's go meet the others.
Sure.
I reckon we've only got a few minutes to get out of here.
If we're lucky.
Was that a gunshot?
It sounded like one. Come on.
And how exactly are we getting out of here?
I ain't too sure. This is what tends to happen when you leave Trelawney in charge of planning. Oh, garnish no meat. Probably involve us dressing up as dancing girls and can-canning off the side. Nice uniform, by the way.
Thanks. I'd give anyone a job these days. Anyway, we shouldn't give ourselves away till we know we need to. Maybe we could still blend into the crowd when it all goes crazy.
Which it surely will. To the bar, senor!
I hope you had fun, sir.
In the time of my life. You boys sure know how to put on a show.
That's wonderful. Ah, look, there's your friend.
Sir, my friend is...
don't be a sore loser, friend.
There's something I don't like about the pair of you.
There's plenty I don't like about you, but I have the good manners to keep my mouth shut.
There he is! Shoot that man!
Never a dull moment.
Yeah, that's one way of putting it.
So, how much did we get?
A few thousand, I think. Pretty good.
Yes, indeed.
And this watch, apparently it's worth a bunch. Swiss, a Reutlinger or something?
Nice watch. Yes, it's a Reutlinger, all right.
We'll give it back then. All right, come on, let's get out of here.
Excuse me.
Hey, do I know you?
Mr. Well, I believe we've met.
We have?
At that ghastly party.
Oh, Evelyn Miller.
Unfortunately so, Mr.
Arthur Morgan, at least sometimes.
Can I say something rude?
Sure.
The mayor thinks you robbed him. To be clear, he wasn't very upset about it. He rather liked you.
Okay.
Do you, can you steal things?
Is there a reason you're asking me to incriminate myself, Mr. Miller?
Well, I'm sorry. Have you met? This is Rainsfall, a great chief, and his son, Eagle Flies.
Gentlemen, yeah, we saw you in the wagon train crossing the river at Cumberland Falls. And at the party, you were upstairs.
You have great powers of observation.
Yes, my people, if we are even a people anymore. We've fought hard. We've made peace treaties, and those treaties were broken. And we've been moved and punished and punished and moved.
I'm sure.
And now I am told we are to be moved again.
Clearly contravening the peace treaty signed 3 years ago.
This will lead to war.
No, my son, it will not. We cannot fight another war. They have got stronger, and we have become far weaker, Mr. Morgan.
Well, it's a bad business.
It's to do with oil. I know it is. But I need the proof. I believe there were some prospectors who were on their land a few months ago who have filed reports with Leviticus Cornwall and the state government claiming huge reserves of oil under their land.
So, you want me to try and steal it?
obviously they can't. And even more obviously, I would be useless. Listen, I realize that it is a ridiculous request, but we're very desperate.
Now, I'm not a do-gooder, Mr. Miller. Gentlemen, I'm very sorry for your predicament, but I'm a working man. I got problems of my own.
We will pay you very handsomely, Mr. Morgan.
How much?
I told you, they're all mercenaries.
There's a price on my head in two states, my friend. The government doesn't like me any more than it does you. Like you, I've been running for as long as I can remember. And like you, my time here is nigh undone.
We understand, and we will pay.
Thank you.
You meet my son in a couple of days near Citadel Rock, just west of the oil fields.
Okay.
We are very grateful for your help.
Gentlemen, that appointment with the senator. We should head over there.
It's a waste of our time. And his. No.
We must try everything. Come along.
Hello, Mr. Miller. The counselor wants to apologize. He can see you now.
We've been waiting I don't know how long.
Or next month, if you'd like to reschedule.
Come. Perhaps the senator won't mind waiting. Yeah.
you doing, Mrs. Adler?
How are you? Been quite a journey since I joined you fellas.
Yes.
And now you and Dutch have joined high society. Oh, Lord above.
Yeah, it seems so.
I think my days in polite society are over.
Well, I just saw Bill Williamson at a party at the San Denise's mayor's house. If he can do it, anyone can.
You get any leads?
Yeah, I think so.
You know so, Arthur Morgan. Come on. We need to talk. Mrs. Adler, will you excuse us?
When are you going to let me come robbing with you, Dutch?
My lord, a few more like her, we could take over the whole world.
A few more like her, there wouldn't be much of a world left.
Yes, perhaps.
Now, the trolley bus station.
I went down there. I took a look at it. I think we can hit it.
I ain't never robbed in a city before.
Yeah, well, you leave the planning to me. You'll ride with me.
Always. Is it just you and me?
No, we'll need one more, I reckon.
I say Lenny.
Not Micah.
Well, that depends if you want a massacre or a payday.
No, I wish that there was something I could do to make the two of you get along better.
Well, that's easy. Make him change.
Very funny. What is that?
It's Kieran!
What the hell have they done to me?
Look, there in the tree line.
Everybody take cover! Or Crystal Boys are coming!
Over there. Charles, you take the side door there. Arthur, you take the windows in the back. Go!
What the hell?
I'm unaccounted for.
That's it.
Hey!
I said, ah!
Sadler. She's still out there! Cover me.
Okay.
This is Adler!
Miss all this? Come on, Arthur!
Now we go back. We need you in the house, Mrs. Hatch.
Oh, no, they don't.
Okay?
I think so. Except for Kieran here. Poor kid. Mr. Swanson, could you take this boy and bury him someplace near, but not too near?
Of course. Charles, help me with the body.
We need to get this place cleaned up. Mr. Pearson, Miss Grimshaw.
Already taking care of it. Come on now, work.
Colm O'Driscoll. That man can really hate. So can I, Arthur. So can I. We need to get moving. Away from here.
So we should start looking for another camp.
You ain't thinking big enough, Arthur. You ain't seeing the vastness of our problems and our opportunities.
I'm not sure I get you.
You will, son. You will. Meet me near the trolley station. We got work.
Shall we?
Yep.
Kieran, that poor kid we spared from O'Driscoll's gang up in the mountains is dead. They chopped his head off and tried to kill the lot of us. Whole place gives me the creeps.